This video is possible due to the funds donated by people in Patreon who together reached the $90 milestone. Thank you. This is a full Windows 10 PC computer and a stick. And this is the next generation of that computer. I have talked in the past about this device, a stick capable of turning any monitor into a full computer. I have also shown its capabilities on the gaming side of things, even being able to run games like Fallout 3 and Mass Effect 2 with some tweaks and effort. However, that compute stick, which had a lot of weird issues with things like Bluetooth, was replaced by a new Chinese generation of Intel sticks, and many of you seem quite interested in seeing how much things have changed on the newer ones, and that is what we're going to talk about today. Here's the thing though, for this generation of sticks there's a ton of variants with different OS compatibilities and specifications, and they tend to have similar boxes and exteriors, often being externally separated by some really small details. What I have right here is the SDK1AW32SC, an Intel Atom X5C8300 Intel HD device with 2GB of RAM. This is almost identical to the SDK1A32SC model, except for the fact that this one I have is limited to 32-bit Windows because it uses drivers that are not available for 64-bit, which is really weird. So if you're looking to own one of these, make sure to look at the model on the box and make sure the pesky W is not there. If you're looking for something with a little bit more kick, there are versions of this stick out there using an M3 CPU, which is basically a low power consumption i3. And there's even a stick with an M5, a low power consumption i5, which is pretty impressive but also pretty damn pricey in comparison with the other sticks. So back to what my budget actually allowed. This one that I have here is still pretty neat. It is slightly bigger than the original one, but now has two full USB ports, one of them being USB 3.0. And the Bluetooth and Wi-Fi actually work okay this time, unlike the frustrating Bluetooth of the original, but how is it going to do as a gaming machine? The X5C8300 is a newer Atom than the C3735F in the original compute stick, so it should be better, but still, under the one in the Jupiter Win. The first thing I decided to try was Portal 2 on all the lowest settings, where this PC averaged around 20, and with some very dramatic graphical production, it hits closer to 30, which are numbers comparable with the first stick, not that much of the difference I expected. I was curious to see if this would do better on something a bit more modern, so I decided to start Rocket League, a game that was unusable on the old stick. On this one, on all the lowest settings, just the training mode could barely break 18 FPS, which is a bit discouraging. However, with some creative tweaking taken from my last Rocket League on GPT-Win video and an internal resolution of 30%, I was surprisingly able to get some very blurry but usable performance in practice mode. So I decided to be brave and try to play a 2v2 online match on the settings, and it did quite well, as you can see. I mean, my skill is still pretty much bad, but at least the performance is manageable with some effort. And that made me curious regarding another game that I had not touched in a while, Borderlands 2. This shooter uses the same engine as Rocket League, but it is also much more flexible to modifications, so I wonder how it will do. A question that I was unable to initially answer because the game will simply get stuck in a loading screen. I decided to explore further though, and the process that I used to reduce the graphics to some rather extreme levels is better explained on a separate Borderlands 2 video that should go out with this one. To my immense surprise, the game actually started with these changes, and while glitchy, blurry, and completely textureless, it managed to boot an impressive 30 FPS even while in combat, which is way more than I expected to get out of this. And to finish, a failed experiment, CS:GO. As I have mentioned many times in the past, CS:GO is not particularly a very tweakable game, but it does serve as a useful benchmark to measure the performance of a computer. And in this case, all settings to the lowest and 800x600, it barely managed to break 17 FPS average. If you apply the custom AutoXX settings from my CS:GO on Intel HD video, it gets a bit over one more frame per second, so yeah, not that good. Still, it is interesting to see just how this technology continues to evolve. I'm curious to see how the M3 or M5 version will perform compared to, say, a cheap laptop. But those prices are likely to keep me away for a while. For now, I will add this device to my list of platforms for experimentation for future videos. Thank you if you donated so I could buy this device. See you on the next video.